Welcome to London. First things first, can you introduce yourself and mention your role in the band?
Okay, we are Måneskin. Mm-hmm. I'm the voice, he's the guitarist, she's the bassist, and he's the drummer. Ethan.
So this is not the first time you're playing in London, right?
No, it's the third time actually.
Yeah, we
played here like twice when we did our tour in Europe. And now we're back and we're so happy to be back.
And how does it compare with an Italian show?
It's quite different because of course here we're like building from the start, so it's nice to be back like in smaller venues and really be close to the people and maybe see a lot of people that don't know you, and you have like to convince them in a way of your music and who you are. That's really a different kind of feeling than we have in
Italy.
Yeah,
that's exciting. Yes.
In Italy, you are known for these extravagant and a bit provoking live shows. What do you aim to do with your music?
Well, I don't know. I think we just use the shows and the music in general to express ourselves and express what we think and what our values are. And when we're on stage, that's just the best for us.
Yeah.
It's our favorite moment because we really feel close to the audience and we can really just be ourselves and do whatever we want, and that's the best part of our job.
Yeah, we just try to be different to the other artists, so we try to build our own show and be really recognizable when you see us.
A question for everyone: how would you describe your music in three words?
Energic?
Yeah.
Wonderful?
Awesome.
Incredible.
Incredible.
And the last one.
Måneskin.
Måneskin.
Another question for everyone. What is your first good memory of being part of Måneskin?
I think one of our first memories is when we started to play together in the street. At first we were like 16 years old and we went to this very known street at Rome, in Rome, and we just stayed there and we played until like the cops came after us. And it was really fun and it was really nice. It really got us close and it made us even more friends than we were.
Yeah.
We started to know each other and stand together, even if it was a little bit tough at first, but it helped us a lot to improve our stage presence too, because we had like to grab people's attention. So it was really fun and
yeah,
a nice experience.
We were doing like everything on our own, so we like built it this great friendship, and now it's continuing. And I don't know, we're loving each other now. Yeah, we have a lot of memories. I can't choose one, just one.
Have you already recorded songs for the new album, or do you plan to do it here?
We started like writing the new album, but
yeah.
We won't tell you nothing.
How does it work, the writing process? Is there someone who comes first with the idea, with the music, with the lyrics?
There's not like a fixed scheme, but sometimes I just came out with some lyrics and we start to play on these lyrics, or sometimes we have a guitar riff or a bass riff and we just start to build the song from it, but we don't have like a fixed scheme to
yeah,
that song.
It really depends. We just try to not fall into the same things over and over. We just try to do whatever we feel in the moment, so we can always try different things. So yeah, that's it.
Group question: who is your model music wise?
We have
kind
different
of different
tastes.
So
it's really difficult to say.
For me, I would say Arctic Monkeys and Harry Styles.
Yeah.
For me, probably Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars, and Wolfpack. For me, I think Led Zeppelin, Red Hot Chili Peppers are the best kind of music.
Yeah, now we're just like evolved into a new kind of more rock music, so I would say Harry Styles and Led Zeppelin too. We're inspiring from that.
Yeah. What would you say has been one highlight of this tour?
I don't know really.
Maybe
the last one.
Maybe first time they told us we're going to have a big tour, and it was like great notice and great news, and we were really excited. And first time they tell you you're gonna have a huge tour, it's like shocking.
Yeah, of course, the first time. Yeah,
and
that's
I think the first show and
the last
show.
But the last two,
maybe.
The most extravagant thing a fan did for you?
Oh my god.
Allowed.
Yeah.
Sometimes in our meet and greets, like there's some family that come to see us, and sometimes the moms are a bit, I don't know, inappropriate with me, like they just throw the babies to Victoria and they start like saying weird things, and I'm like, okay.
Touching his ass.
Yeah, sometimes it happens. I'm kind of used to that.
That's true.
Thomas, there is this nickname you are known by, El Cobra. Oh. Can you tell us how it originated?
Okay, this nickname went to X-Factor, and I have one tattoo in the
yes,
mind
sure,
of this
sure.
nickname. Yeah.
Oh. That's why.
That's why. Yeah.
The Cobra.
The Cobra.
Victoria, it's not so common to see a female embracing the bass guitar. How did it start, and did you ever consider changing instrument?
No, I really...
She was not good with guitar.
Yeah,
so
that's
she started
true.
Playing
yeah,
bass.
At first I was yeah. like playing guitar at my school, in middle school, and the teacher said that I was really bad doing it, so she gave me a bass guitar and told me, okay, try this, it's easier. I don't know, I felt in love.
But it's not easy.
No, it's not easy.
It's not true.
Ethan, you were the last one to join the band. How did it happen?
Okay, that's a strange story. Strange story because yes, they just found me on Facebook on a group that was called like Finding Musicians in Rome. And I just wrote a topic saying I'm a drummer and looking for a band, etc. etc.
And we were like, we're a band, we're looking for a drummer.
Cool.
And it was love at the first sight.
Yeah, that helps.
And Damiano, the frontman and provocateur, how much training do you do for your stage numbers? I'm thinking, for example, the pole dance.
For the pole dancing, I had like a week of lessons, but all day long, like from early morning to late night, with a trainer, with a girl. She was from Ukraine, I think, and she was really, really good.
Yeah.
But in general, I don't train.
It's just inside of you.
Yeah, it's inside of me.
After listening to some of your production, I cannot stop myself from asking you, who is Marlena?
Marlena is
it's
like...
Our muse is like... it's our muse. We decided to mention her in every song. And she represents our values, like freedom and equality and... I don't know, how can we say it?
Just like freedom of expression,
yeah, freedom
accepting yourself, being confident. Yeah.
Freedom to express yourself and all this stuff. And we wanted to give a name to this topic, to this idea, because for us it was more recognizable if you have a name on it. So it's a girl, but it's also an idea and value, basically.
We saw a picture of you with Simon Cowell. How is he supporting you?
We are starting maybe to work with him, and we are planning like a lot of stuff for here. So we're starting to like begin something here in the UK, and we are so excited about it. He's really nice, and
we're planning
we are
to break out
here
in the UK.
Yes.
Hopefully, he's gonna help us.
Yeah,
he's a great professionist, so it's a honor for us to work with him.
Yes.
Who is the most obsessed here with social network? Do you like stalking people?
Okay, that's me.
Good point.
Good point. Good point.
Good point.
Yeah, probably me.
Yeah, not probably.
Not probably.
Sure.
Yes, or definitely. Okay.
Definitely. Really good. Good point.
Good point.
And finally, who are the artists? We want one Italian and one international. You dream to collaborate
okay.
with?
Okay.
International,
now
it's like the coolest one, or also Rosalia and all these new artists, young artists. And in Italy, I don't know.
Marco Mengoni!
Maybe if they build a band that is completely the same, of us, we will collaborate. Måneskin featuring Måneskin.
Woo! Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.